That's stupid. Internet drama. Let us start by clarifying what I mean when I say drama. Luckily, the folks from First Science have already done the legwork in this regard and phrased the proper definition for drama in the context of their research of the furry fandom. Thanks guys for letting me borrow it. Here are the three defining criteria for the type of drama I am talking about. It involves a conflict between at least two people. Now, I am not sure if I stretch First Science's original meaning of this criteria here, but I would count somebody shit-talking somebody else as the starting point of a conflict between these two, even if the target person does not engage. The subject matter is usually trivial and gets blown out of proportion. Obviously, I am not talking about ousting actual criminals, but stuff like, for example, sensational videos mocking another person for small character flaws. And yes, my examples draw from personal experiences, but I will not name names because, well, that would be too hypocritical even for me. And lastly, what truly makes drama drama, and not just a heated butting of heads, it happens in public, which nowadays often means online. Guess this one is what really turns a completely normal thing, not getting along with everybody, into this dreadful mess I wanna address today. Now that we have a clear idea of what I am talking about when I say drama, let me tell you why I consider it stupid. I used to refer to people indulging in drama as shit-flinging monkeys, because this seemed kind of fitting at first. They are not afraid of getting their hands dirty and enjoy throwing the metaphorical shit at people. However, this picture doesn't hold up under the smallest amount of scrutiny. I mean, drama is usually about the shit other people did, while monkeys throw their own shit, to name just one problem with this analogy. However, I came up with a new one that works a lot better. Imagine a community like, for example, a fandom as an animal. Every animal produces shit, and the bigger the animal, the more shit it produces. And where there is shit, there are flies who live off eating the shit. Now, while it is not a bad thing to have somebody around who processes the shit, so not everything where the animal slash fandom goes is covered in shit, there are some downsides and risks to this system. It can produce drama. This means the flies eating the shit are now content themselves. Instead of saying, oh gross, and turning away, we zoom in for a close-up shot and the only thing visible is the fly doing its thing in a scenery entirely made out of the shit the fandom produced. Great content indeed! However, it gets worse. What if the animal switches diet and produces less shit, or if the fly's population explodes? Now, we have this swarm of professional shit eaters without enough shit to eat on camera to keep the audience entertained. A few things can happen. Best case scenario, they will just roll with it, produce less content and, who knows, maybe even give up on the entire shit eating shtick. Or they branch out to eating the shit of other animals as well and hope the audience will still enjoy it. Worst case scenario, and what really makes me detest drama channels and such, if you run out of real shit to eat on camera, just make it up. Either by intentionally lying, using rumors and conspiracy theories, or misrepresenting something or someone out of willful ignorance. You know, the InfoWars kind of shit. But not all drama content producers are willing to sink this low. They rather employ other methods of making shit up. Like trying to provoke and push until innocent people flip and give them a reaction to milk for more content, or digging up some minor issues and blowing them even more out of proportion than drama already is by definition. I have often seen these two methods used in tandem. Now, why is it so bad if we elevate shit eating to actual content? Well, not only will folks who try to look up the animal slash fandom come across this one-sided content dedicated to close-ups of shit and get an unproportionally shitty first impression. Some viewers will develop a disturbing fascination with this kind of content and start celebrating the flies and how they eat all that shit. And like with a cooking show, some of the fans will eventually develop the desire to try out what they see for themselves. Give the shit a good tasting. And inevitably, some of them will like the taste of shit and maybe even start their own content about eating shit. On top of that, if you keep watching too much content only focused on the shit of an animal, you will start thinking that everything this animal title is about is shared. And from this point onwards, your confirmation bias will ensure that anything related to the animal reminds you of shit, even if there's actually none where you're currently looking. I know what I'm talking about. I have been there myself. I had my phase where I was enjoying watching channels that could be categorized under the bright umbrella of drama. And I ended up creating ANY Opinion Counts, where I tried my hand at it myself. But I quickly realized what should have been obvious. Eating shit doesn't make a healthy diet. And the same goes for the metaphorical shit you keep feeding your brain with. Unnecessarily exposing myself to the artificially generated negativity in what I watched, what I produced myself, and the accompanying comment section tainted my outlook on life and made me miserable. Thankfully, I managed to get off this right before I ended up becoming a fly that can't live without shit anymore myself. I still like climbing on my soapbox for videos like this, but I make it an effort to approach topics from a more balanced perspective and don't focus on individuals and their shortcomings, but rather the bigger picture. You know, avoiding point 1 and 2 from the definition of drama. But there is one more aspect about drama that is inherently stupid due to its paradoxical nature. When something is really amiss, like serial abusers going loose in a fandom or something, a virus in our metaphorical animal, if you will, the flies are often the ones to notice because they are the ones willing to get their hands dirty and don't turn away from the shit in disgust, but actually pay attention instead. However, when the drama people then turn around to the community as a whole and are like, "Hey guys, there is something seriously wrong with this shit. We need to band together and fight this." Nobody will listen to them because all they are known for is being focused on shit and buzzing around butts. And you know what? I can't even blame the communities for dismissing any real incidences reported by drama people. I didn't give them the benefit of the doubt for the longest time when they started going after real predators in a fandom I am in. I had grown deaf to their constant, often exaggerated, if not made up accusations and public mud fights. And you can't tell the difference between drama and legit accusations if you have mentally muted the source. And it is not helping when some drama people report the real issues in their usual sensational, mocking, condescending style. So what is the takeaway from all this? Drama is inevitable and maybe even necessary as a mechanism to keep the shit a community produces under control. You know, calling out bad behavior and making the offender squirm a bit under the scrutiny of a wider circle. But if drama gets idealized and turned into a regular airing program, it takes an unhealthy direction. It will breed negativity and bitterness, will potentially lead to the creation of artificial drama, and the people primarily known to regularly engage in it will lose their credibility in the eyes of the rest of the community. As with nearly everything in life, the dose makes the poison. Following some public mudfight on the side, occasionally calling somebody out, or indulging in drama as a guilty pleasure are all fine and dandy. Just don't let drama take over your life, because that's stupid. In case you couldn't tell, I really don't like drama. I can accept its function as a form of social antibodies that aggressively attack and destroy bad elements, even if it causes a bit of discomfort. But when it gets out of control and becomes its own purpose, drama for drama's sake, just like an immune system that turns on its own body, it becomes a destructive, ugly mess. And because I apparently enjoy making myself suffer, let's talk about another fun topic next time, when I explain why homophobia is stupid.